Everyone knows Craig Pierson, president of Marathon Pipelines. And Craig, I think you are ready to go.
Thanks.
Thank you, Jeff. Thanks for the trust for pulling together a discussion like this. There's not too many places where you can see three folks in a row talk about the same topics from different perspectives. It's the only form of this that I know of, and that's one of the reasons why we like participating. So some of my messages are going to be a little bit different. We're going to tell you about how we do some things. I'm going to get started with a video. What you're going to hear is a program that we call Earning Your Trust, and we just didn't develop it right after Sam spoke. We've had it in the works for quite a while, and it's kind of interesting to see the confluence of those two notions, and we came up with that on our own. So what we're going to talk the most about is how we engage and build a relationship based on trust with our landowners. So API 1162 says you need to communicate within 1/8 of a mile on either side of the pipeline. Basically says that relationship is one size fits all along the pipeline, and we don't see it that way. We do that. We do a quarter of a mile, not an eighth of a mile, but what we try to do is build a relationship with our landowners, and you're going to see a little bit of why we do that. And you first think about, oh my gosh, how are you going to do that? And it's so hard, you're so distant, and we realize that we've got a lot of different people out there. Our contractors come in contact with our landowners, multiple employees, when we do one calls, when we do integrity digs, when we do right-of-way clearing, when we do cathodic protection readings. We've got all kinds of opportunities, so we want to make sure that everyone approaches those landowners trying to build a trustful relationship. So I'm going to hit a video. The video is going to have some funky watermark behind it, and that's happened as Carl was blaming me for all of his computer woes. As we moved our video into his machine, this watermark shows up, so if you can, please ignore it. This is a training video for our employees and contractors. Yeah. You hit this again.
Say okay.
Yeah.
You can hit the return button.
No matter your role at Marathon Pipeline, whether you are an employee or a contractor, you are a representative of the company. At your children's school, at church, visiting with your neighbors, or even at the store, you may be asked about MPL, our pipeline, or our work in the community. Your interaction with the public is important to earn trust. It takes time and effort to earn the trust of stakeholders, trust that can be destroyed in a matter of seconds. That is why it is important to follow our three core
principles.
This is
a demonstration of Flip for Mac.
First is mutual respect and trust. We can't expect others to be good neighbors if we aren't willing to do the same. Be the neighbor you want your landowners to be for you. We are guardians of their safety, and we want them to be guardians of our pipeline. Our second core principle is truthful and timely information. The public can jump to conclusions that we are being secretive if we aren't truthful and timely with information. Be honest. Be proactive in getting messages to the public.
Okay. That's the other thing you get is that yapping voice you get to enjoy the watermark too. So we're trying to set the stage for our employees and contractors helping to build this relationship. So as you walked in, we've got a bunch of these materials that are sitting back out on the table. So this is our Earning Your Trust brochure. And there's four components to it. As you open it up, we're working with our communities, our emergency responders, our schools, and our landowners. Those are the four components of our Earning Your Trust program. So we do mailings, and this is per the 1162 requirements that Jeff and Sam have been talked about. So every other year we send these mailings out. We send out to about 275,000 affected public within a quarter of the mile. That's twice the width that we are required to. And we do that every year. But what we try to do every year is build that relationship with our landowners. And there's about 21,000 of those. We operate in about 15 states and about 5,000 miles of pipe. So how do we do that? First, well, after those one-to-one relationships that we establish and we have people that face-to-face, we still do mailings. And we ask them, what would you open and what would you look at? And it resulted in this tube. That's pleasant. It resulted in this tube, and we thought, if we send this out, will people open it? And I'll tell you about some of the check and adjust that we've done, and in fact, they did. So what we do, we have a population of 4,000 people that we survey, we send this mailing tube, and I'll show you how we do check and adjust, and if it works, then the remaining 17,000 get it the following year. Okay, so we got 21,000 total, a population of 4,000, which we pilot. And then we do a check and adjust, and we did that. This was the next year's mailing after they received this. And what they said was, thank you, got it, we got good information. There's a Tervis tumbler in there, and you can go grab one of these things to get a Tervis tumbler. What they said was, look, we get a lot of information from you. Give us something that we can accumulate it all in. So we built a folder for them. And it's got the information on the folder that we're trying to communicate. So that's that mailing effort. So in 2016, this is going to the pilot group. In 2017, if it works, it'll go to the remaining 17,000. So this is a bit of a depiction of our management system that we build around this. In 2014, we went to a focus group, said what works, resulted in this. Then we did it. Before we send it out to the pilot group, we do a phone questionnaire and we find out how effective is our knowledge within this affected group. We send it out, we do another phone survey, did it work? And then we do another focus group, which ends up resulting in this. So this is our management system approach of how we do this on a yearly cycle, on a yearly basis, trying to figure out how you can reach people through a mailing campaign. That's our plan, do, check, adjust cycle. Sean just got excited if he went to his management system presentation. I got excited as well, if you want to know the truth. Okay, so we've got our landowner contacts face-to-face, out in the field, we've got our mailing, and then on an annual basis, in coordination with about an August 11th timeline, we try to meet face-to-face with our landowners to communicate the 811 message, and then we've got an opportunity, which you'll see with another video, and please deal with the yapping and the watermark, and this will explain what we do on an annual basis. So this is at Ohio State Fair with our landowners in Ohio. We sent them a note that says, if you respond, the first 700 people that respond, we'll give you free tickets to the Ohio State Fair. And so this was on Sunday, July 31st, and we got a fantastic response, and we've got a video that explains what we did there.
This is a demonstration of Flip for Mac.
Today we're here for a couple reasons. The first reason is really to get the 811 message out to the public. And the 811 message is to call before you dig. And it's so important with underground utilities and pipelines that people call before they dig. In addition, we are recognizing we have a special program within Marathon Pipeline called Earning Your Trust. And today we have a great opportunity to interface with our landowners to get their input and how can we do things better.
This is a demonstration.
It is all about having a partnership with them, not only from year to year, but for generations to come, where ultimately we help guard their safety and they help guard our pipeline. That's the end goal of Earning Your Trust. We chose Ohio for a couple reasons. One is we have a lot of growth in the state of Ohio. We're building a new pipeline called Cornerstone Pipeline, and we have a lot of existing pipelines already here. And so we have new landowners and existing landowners. So
this
it's a great
a
opportunity to do something right here in our home state.
When the landowners came in, they first went through a registration, and then we took them to a booth where we called Working Together, and they got a ticket, which they could later take to spin the wheel, where if they spun the wheel and they could answer a question correctly, they could win a $15 gas card or tickets to a show. They lost, they got a mug, but how they had to get the right answer or visit our
this
other booths.
This is a demonstration.
And we
a
had
flip
our pipeline
app.
Finder booth where we showed the app and we could show them how the app worked and where our pipeline is. And we had a smart pig. It's a pig that we run through a 10-inch pipeline, and it's probably about 25 feet long. And we had a number of landowners that asked, how do you maintain your pipes? And we could take and we could show them this smart pig and explain what each section does. And there was some earning your trust in action once they could see that and understand that.
This is a demonstration of Flip4Mac.
So that was a hoot. It was fun sitting down with landowners, and we'd go talk to them, and they first think you're trying to sell them something. And you begin the conversation, no, I want to know how it's working. How did we treat you? And how have you been treated? And you hear some great stories, and for the most part, we've done a pretty good job. People felt like they were treated very well. We had some really thoughtful questions. Lady who lays up at night, she says, what I worry about is, I know where the pipeline is, and there's a nearby railroad. She says, I worry about a derailment that hits the pipeline. That's what I worry about. So we went to our Pipeline Finder app, and so show me where the pipeline is, and here's my deck, and here's my backyard, here's where the pipeline goes, here's where the railroad is, and there was enough separation, and I could explain, because she's a valid concern, it has happened. I could explain, look, been there, done that, we've had a derailment near a pipeline, you're fine. Worry about something else. You don't need to worry about that. And there were other instances about, yes, I do wonder, how do you maintain your pipeline? You go show them that internal inline inspection pig, and it's like they can start understanding that much better. We also got some great feedback. There was a Air Force colonel in Dayton. She had become very upset with us on how we treated her when she bought the place and she was doing landscaping, and she says, I came back here, though, because our right of relations person, Dave Wisner, he treated me right, and he brought me back to where that's why I'm here. And then she told another story where we had someone that didn't treat her right again. It was a contractor, and she may end up doing a video for us, a training video for us, so we can, you know, at best penetrate the audience we're trying to penetrate of our employees and contractors. So that's our landowner, earning your trust with landowners. We're also schools. We're targeting schools within 1,000 feet of our pipeline, and we are visiting them with a checklist, and you can see this checklist, pipeline emergency checklist for school officials. And we will have all of them done by the end of the year. We started last year, so there's 135, and this is a face-to-face visit. We usually, quite often, they've got an emergency responder there. We've worked with them, and at times they find out, oh my gosh, their evacuation route is the wrong direction. We've changed the evacuation routes. There's been fences that we've paid for to put a gate in so they can go a different direction. And that's been really a great program. People love doing that. So now our emergency responders, trying to educate them. This is a tough audience, as we talked. They're busy. Almost all of them are volunteer firemen. They're doing this on their own time. They're changing all the time. And trying to build a relationship with them, yes, we do send out a mailer. And to be honest with you, it is coordinated with other operators. We do coordinate it because they are inundated. And we have tried to minimize it, and we give them a brochure that speaks specifically to Maryland Pipeline, and other, some of the other operators do the same. So that is coordinated, in, at least in a lot of the circumstances that we're aware of, Sam. This is a tough program, a lot of geography to cover, but in addition to that mailing, we go and we meet with them, with our employees, and we're trying to establish a relationship with those emergency responders. We find out what kind of equipment they we need, and some, we have some funding that we can help them with. So we hope to be earning their, the trust with the responders. On our website, we try to be more transparent and get information pushed out. And you can get our Pipeline Finder app on the website. We're constantly trying to make sure that we're getting the right information out there. So lastly, Sean mentioned Cornerstone Pipeline in the video. You saw it on another list. We've got a pipeline that we recently completed in southeastern Ohio. When we were meeting with at the Ohio State Fair, we were meeting with someone who's a new landowner. And I said, so how do we deal? So he's just been through the right-of-way acquisition process, just been through construction. How did we treat you? And with that one individual, he said, you treated us fine. He talked about some other dealings, which he didn't talk about in quite those terms. And fortunately, he spoke highly of our contractor when they had a problem and they needed help. Our contractor helped, and that's what we were trying to get our contractors to behave the way we want them to behave so we have a good long-term relationship. So this timeline, what we're going to do, basically the end game is we're gonna communicate through some surveys to find out how we've done through the construction project, and then next June we're gonna have a focus. We're gonna have a focus group where we bring them in. They are blinded. We've got someone who, like, where you're getting a focus group to analyze a commercial. We use people that can do that, and we'll find out how are you treated, so we can check and adjust through the next pipeline that we build. So that's a bit how we handle things, and we're trying to build relationships with people who aren't always interested in having a relationship. They don't need that noise in their life, but we want them to still understand it, so they guard our pipeline and we guard their safety. Got handouts in the back if you're interested.